My name is Kristin Patrick. I am a postdoctoral fellow at UCSF in the Guthrie lab. Many cancer lines will have mutations in the pathway that we study, which is called mRNA splicing. So if we understand fundamentally how this pathway works, then we could better understand, well, what is going on in a cancer cell. And then the next step for, you know, some kind of a biotech or a pharmaceutical company would just be to say, okay, we know what's wrong with the cancer cell, let's try to fix it. I've kind of, as long as I can remember, knew I wanted to be a research scientist, which is kind of strange. I am from New York, I'm from the East Coast. My family is not scientific at all. I come from a really blue-collar family. So definitely, well, my parents didn't really go to college and they definitely don't have PhDs. Most of my work is sort of molecular biology, I call it. So I'm at the bench, pipetting. We don't do a lot of microscope work, some computational analysis. I think a lot of biology is becoming more computational now. So for the most part, if I have a question as a postdoc, I go to the other postdocs in the lab. And it's nice to have just a group of other really smart, excited, passionate people to bounce ideas off of.
Hey, Ann, can you take a look at this for me?
Sure. Thanks. So what do you think? This one?
I mean, the best way I would say to, you know, as a young person interested in science at the high school or college level, you need to get into a lab. You need to get on the bench. You can just start listening to science, and you know, watching TED Talks is a good way to just see what people are doing, see what questions people are asking in biomedical research. Research is not about being book smart. You know, you go your whole academic career through college, grades are important. You know, you need to read and be able to regurgitate and memorize, and then you get to scientific research on the bench, and it's a totally different skill set. You know, you could be the smartest person ever and be a horrible scientist. But the thing that really, I think, separates a good motivated scientist from a bad one is that when something fails, you think of why, and you think, well, how can I fix it? And how can I change my experiment so I get the answer that I want? And that's really how my brain works. What motivates me to come into lab is to fix that problem. So, you know, I had a failure and now I have an idea of how to fix it. Is my idea right? You know, I think the most important thing is to be a hard worker. So persistence and just general curiosity. Again, you know, if you don't care, then when your experiment fails, you're not going to want to do it again, right? So you have to be curious about what you're doing. You have to be excited about science. You know, the funny thing is people think that researchers are, oh, you have a PhD, you're so smart, blah, blah, blah. You know, you really don't have to be that smart to do science. I think you really just have to be curious and a hard worker and you'll be successful. Thank you.